Sonder family, it is a wonderful Wednesday, and we have gathered together today. We're in our annual supplement, right? But the new book, the new word for this is actually life workbook. So I'm trying to retrain my brain to remember to call this the life workbook. And it is, that is such an appropriate name for this, because we really get to dig into a lot of fun areas in our life. It's one of the reasons I chose Live Your Story as our opener today. I'm Jennifer Ogilvy, and I'm coming to you from the Dallas, Texas area. We have a very balmy summer day. We thought fall had come, but it was a trick. So here we are sweating it out in Texas. And then also on our call tonight in the chat is the wonderful Malika. So if you have any questions about Silk and Sonder or what we're doing, she's going to try to clarify. She just popped on to wave to you, and she's going to be providing that support in our chat as we dig into a couple of pages of our annual supplement or our life workbook. See, it's hard to teach an old dog new tricks. I am seeing, oh, cold and rainy in Minnesota. I'm so jealous, Brenda. I wish, I'm ready to pull out the sweaters and get cozy and have pots of soup every night for dinner. I saw that we have folks from across our nation, so that's kind of fun, but we also have some friends from across the pond. So welcome. I love that the Silk and Sonder family can be so united and connected through this wonderful stuff called technology. Even when it goes glitchy, we're still very grateful for it. So speaking of, double check your chat and make sure that it is set to everyone. And I know sometimes, depending on how you signed up, if you or signed in through Eventbrite or through Zoom, it can kind of sometimes mess up that chat setting, and it'll always go default back to host and panelist. If you see host and panelist next to, you know, in your chat box, just know that it's only going to Malika and me, and we want everybody to be able to share. Oh, that's fun. Somebody's going to a friend's single release party. Woo, that sounds like a lot of fun. So some of you guys have cold weather. Maybe that's coming down, the rain and that sort of stuff. So this afternoon or evening, depending on where you are, you will need this book, your life workbook, or you can grab some paper, some scrap paper. You also, if you can access any of the previous journals you have, maybe 1 or 2 months, we're going to kind of do a fun activity going back and looking through a couple of our journals to be inspired. So you go into the Zoom meeting, yeah, every time, trying to figure out, Donna, I think if you can directly log into Zoom, I think folks end up having glitches when they do Eventbrite. And yes, Stephanie, you get that email confirmation and that should do it. But you know, I can tell you one thing, and doggone it, the next time you log in, you know, technology, right? So it's crazy. Okay, so Jessica does go through Eventbrite, so I'm not sure. And always make sure that you keep your computer updated too, because I forget to do that sometimes, and Zoom has almost daily. So anyway, welcome, welcome, welcome. Let's get going. We're gonna have a lot of fun. These are just fun socials. And I do apologize. You see, there's a link up at the top of my slide deck. There's just something going on with how I was able to pull this to share with you today. So try to ignore that top space. So we're going to be exploring in our life workbook today. And our agenda will look like this. We have, we have a couple of opening activities. We've got kind of a fun one to get our juices flowing. And then we're going to have one where we are going to be inspired to fill out the pages we're working on in our life workbook, but we're going to lean into a couple of the older journals that we have. If you don't have them, that's okay. You'll still be able to do that. We will look at our moments to remember on, which is going to be on page 25, and the happiness jar, which is on page 31. And you guys who have done socials with me know that my two favorite things about the journal are bingo boards and any kind of jar. I just love doing the jars. I feel like I can get so creative. So hopefully, you know, I'll try to stay calm, but I get real excited about bingos and jars. So grab a scrap piece of paper. We are going to have a little bit of fun today by doing some self-care Mad Libs. This is just a way to sort of leave the day you've had behind and lean into some fun. And as you know, with Ad Libs, you just make your list 1 through 15 and answer each little, you know, lined item there. Number one, your name. Number two, your favorite food. And then we're going to have a little fun with all of that information. So I'm going to put on some music while you work on this activity, and then I'll check back in with you in just a few minutes.
We'll be right back.
Okay, that's just kind of fun. I hope that, yes, and you're right, Brenda. Malaka did do a Mad Lib with you before, and so we were excited to be able to bring a little bit of fun and lightness tonight. So I'm going to put on the actual Mad Lib. And then what I'm gonna do, yeah, Pump Chip, that was my point, Robin. I love that song. Everybody kind of starts dancing in their seats when they hear it. So I'll put I'm gonna put on a little instrumental music, kind of low. And what I want you to do is when I turn to the Mad Lib page, read it out loud to yourself, filling in the blanks. And then if something is really funny or sweet or delightful and you loved reading that, those words put together, drop that in the chat to us. Okay, I am dying. These are so great. And I think that you should take the one that made you laugh most and like an affirmation, put it on a post-it note and stick it somewhere where like you know you're gonna need a good laugh, like maybe on your steering wheel or maybe on your computer monitor at work. These were so good. I learned that you guys, some of you are the better than pizza, the, you know, chunkiest person, chunkiest. I love that. Chunkiest person in the world, Reverend Joy. Ellen, that's great. Y'all can just take your pickle and fly it up your wrist. There you go. That's good. Good affirmation. I'm the hungriest person in the world. They can take their doggy and read it up their arm. You guys have to go through these. But today is the day you stop beating yourself up for being so smelly. Heather, that's gotta go like on your steering wheel. And when you're in traffic, you can read that and make yourself laugh. These are great. Oh, Sherry, you're the greatest thing since tacos. That's a pretty big deal. Tacos and pizza. I don't know which one I love the most, but I do know I love Sonderfans. So Thank you for taking time to just lighten up your day a little bit and lean into some joy and happiness and giggles. It's an important thing to do. Just like we forget to breathe, sometimes we forget to laugh. I think I heard recently that children laugh 15 more times a day than adults do. Why do we stop? Why did we ever stop doing that? So find ways to laugh throughout your day. So I want to take a look at this word exploring, because if we're exploring our life workbook, what does that mean? And I've got a couple of fun quotes to share with you. Creative energy comes from knowing you have virtually infinite sources to draw from. We all need that creative energy. And some of the sources you can draw from are your journals. And that's one of the reasons we're going to be using a couple of those older journals today. Again, if you joined us a little bit late, see if you can get your hands on maybe this month's journal and maybe a couple other months if you've got a quick moment to do so. So while we often think of creativity as a spontaneous act. Remember, those of you who have been with us a few months, we had a whole month where we looked at our lives through the lens of spontaneity, and we realized some of us were struggled with that a little bit. But creativity often comes from that constant effort to observe and take in the world, right? Slowing down and noticing, being a noticer, to build a reservoir of inspiration. Start by examining your current behavior, and you're there because we do work through these journals every month to get to know ourselves better. So where do you draw your inspiration? Is it from looking at the past? Is it from people that are in your life? Is it from books that have stayed? You know how sometimes you just read a book and it stays there. You know, teachers, folks in your past, or even just like yourself, like be inspired by how far you've come. I love it when every once in a while we'll be digging into something deep and one of you will pop up and say, you know, but we've survived every hard day we've ever been through so far. And that's such a good reminder. Be inspired from yourself. Look at your rituals, those things that you do every day to become the best version of you that you can be. And then ask yourself, how do you replenish your energy? And we spend a lot of time digging into that. And so that's why we're going to take our old journals and we are going to create a very personal poem. And I think it'd be great to either, you know, maybe on inside our book, you know, like at the front cover, if that space is still empty, you could put that there. You could find a notes page in this month's journal. But this is going to be something that's going to be very personal to you. So I want to share the poem that is on the screen that you see. This poem was written by the other facilitator named Jennifer Krittner. And what she did, we're going to take our past journals or look through your annual supplement and review all the pages, you know, just kind of go through and thumb through. And you're going to write out 5 different sentences from 5 different sections or areas in those journals. And that will create your own poem. Now, if you don't have that, you can just write your own poem, or you can kind of, maybe you've got a couple of books that you draw inspiration from and you could pull out that. Oh, Kim, you were asking here we go. Where do you draw your inspiration? What are your rituals and how do you replenish your energy? That one's so important. Yes, that we've talked about that replenishing, right? That was one of our recent things. So I want to tell you about this poem and then I'll give you time to work on your poem. Yes, Nat, if you've got cards or letters that are nearby that you could pull from somebody else. So Jennifer Krittner wrote this poem, Calming to My Soul, is from an acrostic poem from one of the journals that she had. I want to feel lighter. That was from a weekly spread when she answered the question, how do I want to feel this week? You know how we do that? We claim that feeling. The next line is tired but inspired. And that came from a reflections page. Rest will help balance my life. That was an intentions page when we dug into balance. And I happen to know she was traveling a ton during this time, and she was really having trouble. And so she was going to, one of her intentions was to prioritize that rest. And then her final statement is, it was a good day. And that just came from a weekly spread. So I'm going to play a few moments of music as you lean into making your own scrap poem. And if you have time and you'd like to drop part of that or all of that into the chat, we'd love to see that. And the bonus of doing this is that it's going to guide us into the page that we're working on in our life workbook tonight, our moments to remember. All righty. I'll come back in just a few moments. Thank you. Okay, I'm tearing up because I know some of you guys have are the regulars of Silk and Sonder, and you have shared some parts of your journeys, and I'm seeing those words, and you really you stirred my soul. I didn't think this would be a get the Kleenex social. You know, we have those. So I'm so proud of you for looking back over those pages. I do tend to keep most of my journal when I'm done. I actually have like this notebook and I kind of just slice off the pages. I know Nona Nat does a beautiful job. Yeah, every social is a tissue social. Nona Nat deconstructs hers and makes new binding and puts them in. And I know some folks, when the month is over and they toss them, but I tend to keep the pages of those soul moving things. And I hope that by you leaning into this activity and kind of taking those chunks, they're almost like little pictures of the past, right? And it's just it's showing you like, okay, and here you are right now, today, at this very moment, on a wonderful Wednesday, gathered with one of the best communities I've ever been a part of. So, this is something that you can do anytime if you're feeling down, pull out a few journals and go pull those affirmations that you know, are daily affirmations or reflections from daily rituals or responses to journal. Pull out those positive things and put those positive things all in one place, you know, five, six lines. Make your own scrap poem to remind you of how awesome you are and that there are good days. You know, life is ebb and flow, and we're gonna have hard times, but when we can look back and see how strong we are and taking those phrases and go, I know exactly where I was at that moment when I wrote that, and here I am today. So I'm really proud of you for leaning into something that might have stirred up some emotions. Thank you so much for being so candid and very supportive of each other. Again, best community ever. So now that we've kind of reflected back in our journal, that's a great segue to picking up our life workbook and opening it to page 25. And this is your moment to remember. And it does say the directions are at the top. Again, I tend to do so much better when I'm with you guys, when I have to really do deep dives. It's just nice to have that supportive community as we're leaning into the stuff. So the directions are write down those special moments that pop up that you never want to forget. Maybe things that children say, a time you laughed so hard you cried. Maybe that was tonight, when you realize that you are indeed way better than tacos or pizza. And other things that, you know, things that maybe make you felt proud, just those moments. But there are some other ways to embrace this page. So let's look at those as well. You can use this month's theme of surrender. And I have shared this has been a hard theme for me because it's been so stirring. And I said, I know I'm gonna grow through these journal prompts and just thinking about what does surrender mean in my life and what do I need to surrender? What am I still holding on to that I just, and it's keeping me from better things because I'm hanging on to it. So you can kind of look at the moments of maybe things that you've surrendered or things that you're going to surrender. Yes, Angela, it has. I did the weekly setup this week. Sunday night. And if you were there, you know, I referred to Brené Brown talking about wholehearted people, and they are the ones that are very vulnerable. And she has these guideposts that when you can give up and surrender some things in your life, you cultivate such, you know, the other just such an opposite thing of what it is. And I had shared that, you know, for me, I'm very fearful. We're early retirees. Stock market's got me crazy, and I'm very fearful about, lack of, and I have so much in my life. I've got to let that go. I've got to surrender. So, anyway, I'm going off on a tangent because I think this is a really tough theme because we've all got that stuff that's keeping us back from being the best version of who we can be. So you might want to think about some of the moments to remember that you're going to surrender or that you've already surrendered and where you are. And I know some of you have had some big life surrenderings, for lack of a better word. And where are you now? And list the things that you've benefited by surrendering. You can also create a future moments to remember. Visualize what things you want to be reflecting on. So that's kind of casting that out into the universe so that you can claim that and lean into that. You can also pull out those journals. I asked you to grab them and the phone photos, right? Or your calendar. And it can tell you the things that, you know, just like, yeah, I've got 30 or 25 beautiful things that I can just fill this up with if I just go through my photo roll on my camera. A hint is you can start with sticky notes, a blank notes page, use a pencil to sketch it out, whatever. You don't have to do all the lines. You can cover those numbers with washi tape and just do a free write. You can focus on the life-changing moments that shifted perspective. And we just talked about that because I know that there are medical journeys, there are marriage journeys, there are journeys with your people that you love that you've had to make really tough decisions. So there's a lot of ways we can frame this beautiful page. You might also want to create some categories. You could do a timeline by decades, or every 5 years of reflection like that. School, work, children, siblings, birthdays, holidays, you get that. So I'm just going to play a ton of music for you while you respond to this page and embrace the moments in your life. And then you, if you're comfortable, drop in the chat what you're writing about or what it made you think of, that you have surrendered and you have come out so much stronger, anything that is resonating with you. And I'll check back in just a few minutes. Thank you. I know that this one is definitely a deep dig, and some of you guys are going way back and remembering things like your first kiss. Yes, yeah, some of the best memories are not dramatic at all. Brenda said she remembers perfectly sitting with her daughter in the basement learning about triangles. And for some reason, that moment just stuck with her. And those are those sweet, sweet moments that we want the entire family to know about, that we were just, real people and doing real things. Nona had shared at the beginning of this activity that she has done has tried to do a really good job about framing the holes, those deep, dark times in her life, and just really figuring out how to move away from that. And one of the things that Brené Brown says in her research is that we got to feel it all. If we numb to the tough stuff, we ultimately also numb the really good stuff. So it is important to lean into those kinds of things. So, Diane, just give yourself some grace. And yes, just claim the future. Claim the future. Life is tricky and every day's a new day. And we all are doing the best we can. So we can leave this list now. It's there. It is there. You may want to work on this for the rest of the month or a couple of months. That's the beauty of this. Things don't have to always be finished. I have some journal prompts still waiting for me to tackle from a couple of months ago that I just wasn't ready to do. So that's the beautiful thing about our journals, is that just because the month is over doesn't mean we have to, say goodbye to that. So take maybe some things that have been floating around in your head. Sometimes these can be hard. It might just not be a good day to do it, but you've sat with us and your brain is going. And so give yourself that grace. Let's kind of look at the happiness jar now. This is a really fun activity. And, we have many iterations of using jars in our journals. Sometimes, we may see them thematically based, like, a spontaneous jar or gratitude jars are usually show up. So I have some examples of how the Sonder family has set these jars up. I'm going to scroll through really quickly. And you can set your jar up however you want and maybe be inspired from some previous jars. Some of them were gratitude jars, some of them were empowerment jars. But I love the way the Sonder family inspires. And so you can see, you can trace a coin to fill your jar with little stones or marbles and fill it in with things that bring you joy and make you happy. There's some leaves. Even this time of year, you could do orange leaves because of the fall and the things that the trees are letting go, and they're going to show us how beautiful it is to let go of things. How perfect is that for the month of surrender? So think of the things that you've surrendered that have brought you happiness, and you could frame that with the leaves. Free writing, that's a grateful jar, but certainly you could use that as a happiness jar. Here are some other ways of using that space in your journal. Some little bubbles and shapes. You could fill it with stickers like the one on the left. And, if you're very artistic, I am not, but that's okay. I like to doodle, but you could do like the little labels there. I think those make me think of fortune cookies, or a nice refreshing beverage with those ice cubes that you fill up with things that make you happy. You're welcome. Thank you for posting your page, Leanne. And you could create a bingo board about surrender, or just a happiness bingo board, and you're going to list things that make you happy and then go do them, right? And then I have a whole bunch of suggestions here on how you can fill your jar with things that make you happy. So let me put on some music and I will scroll back and forth and back and forth so that you can be inspired by the Sonder family as you fill up your happiness jar. Again, it can just be words, just a brain dump of the things that bring you joy. Fonder friends, believe it or not, our the time flies when you're having fun. We did some deep digging tonight, so I'm certain that you'll want to work. I know, Brenda, no, I'm not ready to say goodbye either. So you guys, thank you for spending this time with us, and I know you'll want to sit with your life workbook and really dig into that and get that happiness jar filled up. I would love to see it in Sonder family, in the Sonder Club, if you are comfortable with that. We love to see each other's stuff. You guys are so inspiring. to one another and to the facilities. We love to see your stuff. Here are the QR codes to scan, and be sure to take that survey. We do love the feedback. You got the time wrong. I'm so sorry, Jenny. We're so glad you were with us for the time you were with us. This will be recorded. It is being recorded. It will be on our YouTube channel. So if you didn't get your pages filled up and you want to go back and listen to music and work on your pages again, we'd love to see you there. That link is, you can QR code, you know, scan it with your camera right there on the bottom left. I mean, bottom right. I always get my screen mixed up. Bottom right. But we thank you for, you're going to be gone. Yes, Sherry, you'll be on vacation. We'll be thinking about you. Be safe. Yes, and Nona Nat, there is always a jar, like at least once a quarter and maybe more. So we love spending this time. Thank you for being vulnerable, sharing with one another, lifting each other up, and making that beautiful connection. I said the Sonder family is magic, and I, Malika and I loved spending this evening with you guys. Make it a great rest of the week. You're at Hump Day. You're almost there. We'll see you next time, Sonder family. Here come bad news, talking this and that. That's what you want.